പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിന്റെ അത്ഭുതകരമായ സാന്നിധ്യം ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ കൂടാരം മുഴുവനും നിറയട്ടെ.
The same power coming upon you, upon you.
Left her water jar and went back to the city. She said to the people, "Come and see a man who told me everything I have ever done. He cannot be the Messiah. Come, can he?" They left the city and were on their way to him.
28 वचन के आगे उस स्त्री ने अपना घड़ा वहीं छोड़ दिया और वह नगर गई, वहां जाके लोगों से कहा, चलिए एक मनुष्य को देखिए जिसने मुझसे वह सब कहा जो मैंने किया, कहीं वह मसीहा तो नहीं? इसलिए वे लोग नगर से निकले और यीशु के पास आने लगे।
And this woman left Jesus, believing the water jar there. She's going to her city, Samaria, and she tells many people, testifies to many people that she met the Messiah. And verse 39, many Samaritans from that city believed in him because of the woman's testimony. He told me everything I have ever done. So when the Samaritans came to him, they asked him to stay with them, and he stayed there 2 days. And many more believed because of his word. They said to the woman, it is no longer because of what you said that we believe, for we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world.
39वें वचन के आगे उस स्त्री ने यह गवाही दी थी, उन्होंने मुझे वह सब बता दिया जो मैंने किया है। इस कथन के कारण उस नगर के बहुत से सामरियों ने यीशु में विश्वास किया, इसलिए जब वे यीशु के पास आए तब उन्होंने अनुरोध किया, आप हमारे यहाँ रहिए। वह 2 दिन वहीं रहे। बहुत से अन्य लोगों ने उनके उपदेश सुनकर उन पर विश्वास किया। सामरी लोग उस स्त्री से बोले, अब हम तुम्हारे कहने के कारण ही विश्वास नहीं कर रहे हैं, हमने स्वयं उसे सुन लिया है, हम जान गए हैं कि वह सचमुच संसार के मुक्तिदाता हैं।
हालेलुया,
हालेलुया।
See, this is when the Samaritan woman testified about Jesus Christ. The people of Samaria, they came to Jesus, heard the word. They are inviting the Lord to their city, and Jesus is going there, being with them for 2 days. Then the people says to the woman, "It is no longer because of what you said that we believe." For we have heard for ourselves, and we know that this is truly the Savior of the world.
उस औरत की कही हुई बात को उनके नगरवासियों ने सुना, और उसने जो कहा कि मैंने जो किया वो सारी बात उन्होंने कही, और ये कहने के बाद में जब लोग आकर यीशु से मुलाकात करते हैं, वो मुलाकात के बाद में उन लोगों ने उस सामरी स्त्री को कहा, अब तुम्हारे कहने पर हम विश्वास नहीं कर रहे हैं, बल्कि हमने अपनी आँखों से देख लिया है और हम विश्वास कर रहे हैं, यही वो व्यक्ति है जो दुनिया का मुक्तिदाता है।
हालेलुया,
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 हालेलुया।
See, the most important thing is that the Samaritans saying the woman that it is not because of your word, but because the word that we heard from the Lord, we realize that He is truly the Savior of this world. So we believe, we have the strong faith now. Why? Because they heard the word from the Lord directly. That word cleansed their heart, removed their thirst, and they say that we have strong faith that He is from God, He is truly the Savior of the world.
उन लोगों ने उस स्त्री से कहा, अब हम तुम्हारी बातों पर विश्वास करने की जगह पर हम उस व्यक्ति पर इसीलिए विश्वास करते हैं क्योंकि उसने जो कहा हमने सुना, और वो हमने हमारे विश्वास में बदल गया, वो हमारे मन में बसा हुआ है, और हम जान गए हैं वही मुक्तिदाता है जिसका हमको इंतजार था।
हालेलुया,
हालेलुया।
See, the Samaritans received the Lord as their savior. They received the Lord. They received Him in their heart as their Savior.
यहाँ पर हम ये देखते हैं कि सामरियों ने यीशु को पर विश्वास किया, उनको स्वीकार किया, उनके वचन को अपने हृदय में बसा लिया.
And they testified, He is the Savior, the true Savior of this world.
और उन्होंने गवाही दी कि यही वो मुक्तिदाता है जिसका हम राह देख रहे थे।
It's an every time when we hear the word cleanses our heart.
जब भी हम प्रभु का वचन सुनते हैं, सुनते सुनते वचन हमारा हृदय शुद्ध करता
है। And the word gives us faith to believe in His name.
और वही वचन हमको विश्वास देता है कि हम उनके नाम पर विश्वास करें।
The word gives us knowledge about the Lord.
प्रभु का वचन हमको जानकारी ज्ञान देता है प्रभु के बारे में।
And that word cleanses our heart and heals our sickness.
और वही वचन प्रभु का वचन हमारे हृदय को शुद्ध करता है, हमारी बीमारियों से हमको मुक्ति देता है.
Psalms 107:17, some were sick through their sinful ways, and because of their iniquities endured affliction. They loathed any kind of food, and they drew near to the gates of death. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and He saved them from their distress. He sent out His word and healed them and delivered them from destruction.
भजन संहिता 107 की तरफ हम वापस आते हैं. इसमें 17वें वचन के आगे, कुछ अपने अपराधपूर्ण आचरण के कारण रोगी और कुकर्मों के कारण पीड़ित थे. उनको भोजन से अरुचि हो गई थी और वे मृत्यु के द्वार तक पहुंच चुके थे. तब उन्होंने अपने संकट में प्रभु की दुहाई दी और प्रभु ने उन्हें विपत्ति से बचाया. उसने अपना वचन भेजकर उन्हें स्वस्थ किया और विनाश से उनकी रक्षा की.
Here we heard that somewhere sick through their sinful ways.
हाँ, हम पढ़ते हैं कि कुछ लोग अपने पापपूर्ण कामों के वजह से बीमार पड़ गए.
Somewhere sick through their sinful ways.
कुछ लोग बीमार और पीड़ित थे क्योंकि उनके कुकर्मों के कारण.
Many times sickness comes from sins.
कई बार बीमारियां पाप के राह से होकर आती.
Maybe our own sins, maybe the sins of our ancestors.
हो सकता है हमारे पाप हो या हमारे पूर्वजों के पाप हो.
So here the word reveals somewhere sick through their sinful ways, and because of their iniquities endured affliction.
वचन कहता है कुछ लोग अपने पापपूर्ण आचरण के कारण रोगी और कुकर्मों के कारण पीड़ित थे.
They loathed any kind of food and they drew near to the gates of death.
उनको भोजन से अरुचि हो गई थी और वो मृत्यु के द्वार तक पहुंच चुके थे.
You know many people can't eat whatever the tasty food be, they can't eat. They loathed any kind of food and they drew near to the gates of death. Means they are in the end of their life. The reason the word says that, because they sinned somewhere sick through their sinful ways. Maybe the sins of our own sins, maybe the sins of our ancestors.
Hum jante hain kuch log स्वादिष्ट भोजन सामने आने पर भी वे उसे खा नहीं सकते. उनमें उनको उसमें रुचि नहीं है. वचन कहता है कि उनको भोजन नापसंद हो गया और उनकी बीमारी उनको मौत के घाट तक लेके चली गई. हम ये भी जाने कि ये बीमारी, ये पाप उनका हो सकता है, उनके पूर्वजों का हो सकता है जो उन पर बोझ बनकर आया है. उस दुख तकलीफ में उन्होंने प्रभु को पुकारा.
And he saved them from their distress.
और उन्होंने उनको उनकी विपत्ति से बचाया.
Say this after me. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble. And he saved them from their distress.
तब उन्होंने अपने संकट में प्रभु की दुहाई दी और प्रभु ने विपत्ति से उन्हें बचाया.
So they cried to the Lord and he saved them.
वचन कहता है कि उन्होंने पुकारा, रोकर पुकारा और तब उन्होंने जवाब दिया.
You know how he saved them?
उन्होंने उनको कैसे बचाया?
Verse 20 says he sent out his word and healed them.
उनको कैसे बचाया? 20वां वचन कहता है प्रभु ने अपना वचन भेजकर उनको चंगाई.
And delivered them from destruction.
और विनाश से उनकी रक्षा की.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lift up your right hand and say loudly, he sent out his word and healed them and delivered them from destruction. Lord, you sent out your word and heal me from my sickness. Save me from this destruction. Come into my life. Save me, O Lord. Send out your word. Heal me. Deliver me. Have mercy on me. Forgive all my sins. Forgive all my iniquities. I have sinned against you.
I confess to you, Lord. I am a sinner. I have sinned against you. I repent about my sins. Come into my life. Forgive me. Forgive me. Jesus. Jesus. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Forgive all my sins. Forgive all my sins. Forgive all my iniquities. Hallelujah. 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 Make me free. I want to be free. I want to be healed. I want to be saved. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Lift up both of your hands to heaven. Praise Him. Thank you loudly. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We ask you to send out your word and heal us. Send out your word and heal my disease. Oh, Lord. We ask you to send out your word. Send out your word and heal my disease. Send out your word and heal me, O Lord. I want to be healed. I want to be touched by you, O Lord. Deliver me from my destruction. Send out your word. Save me, O Lord. Save me, O Lord. I want to be saved. I want to be saved. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. You send out your word and heal my disease. I want to be healed. I want to be healed. I ask you, Lord, to send out your word and forgive my sin. I want to be saved. I want to be saved. Forgive me, O Lord. Forgive my sin. Forgive me, O Lord. I am a sinner. Oh, Jesus. I confess to you, Lord, that I have sinned against you by disobeying your word. By rejecting your love. Have mercy on me. Oh Lord, I ask you to have mercy on me. Forgive me. Forgive me, O Lord. Forgive my iniquity. Forgive my trespasses. Forgive me, O Lord. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Forgive me, O Lord. Forgive me, O Lord. You send out your word and heal my disease. You send out your word and forgive my sin. Forgive me. Forgive me, O Lord. Forgive my sin. Forgive me, O Lord. I want to be saved. Have mercy on me. I am your child. Have mercy on me. I ask you, Lord, to send out your word and deliver your children from all their destruction. Have mercy on everyone here. You send out your word and heal our disease. You send out your word and heal my disease. Because you are my Lord, you are my God, and you are my deliverer, Jesus. I believe in your name. I believe and
proclaim that there is power, mighty power in your name. Oh Jesus, I believe in you, O Lord. Touch me, O Lord. Touch me, O Lord. I want to be free. I want to be free. Heal me, O Lord. Heal me. Heal me. Heal me from my disease. Close your eyes. Let us ask for the mercy of God. Let us agree in our mind that we have sinned. We have sinned against you, Lord. We are sinners. I agree that, Lord, I have sinned against you by rejecting your love, by rejecting your word, by disobeying your commandment. I have gone far away from you, enjoying the pleasures of this world, not remembering your word, but enjoying the pleasures of this world. I gave myself to the devil. I allow him to destroy this temple of yours through my sins. Now in my distress, in my trouble, I come to you, Lord. I come to you asking for your mercy. I realize there is no one to save me. There is no medicine to heal me. Oh Jesus, I come to you asking for your mercy. Do not leave me away, O Lord. There is no one in this world to help me. Only you. I come to you, O Lord. I come to you, Jesus. Do not leave me away, O Lord. Have mercy on me. Forgive all my iniquities. Forgive all my trespasses. I agree that, Lord, I have sinned against you. I have sinned against you, O Lord. Forgive me. Forgive me, O Jesus. I believe that you can forgive my sins, O Lord. I believe you can forgive, only you can forgive me. I believe in your name, O Jesus. You are the Savior. I proclaim it, O Lord, you are my Savior. There is no one in this world to save me. Only you, O Lord. Have mercy on me. Forgive all my sins, all my iniquities. I want to be a true child of God. I want to experience your love, O Lord. I want to be loved by you, O Lord. I want to love you, O Jesus. I want to love you from my heart. I want to obey your word. Give me the grace. Give me one more chance, O Lord. Give me the grace. Come into my heart. You said to the Samaritan woman, if you drink from this water, you will have thirst forever. But if you drink from me, if you drink this living water, if you drink, accept this, the word of God, you will be saved. I want your word. I want your living water. Let it come into my heart. Cleanse me. Sanctify me. Purify me. Jesus. Jesus, 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 oh Jesus, have mercy on me, have mercy on me, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Call upon his name, call upon his name, loudly, loudly. Call upon his name, Jesus. Everyone shout, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Only you can save me. Only you can heal me. Only you can deliver me, O Lord. Do not leave me, Jesus. Jesus, Son of God. You are the Messiah. You are the Christ. Come into my life. Come into my heart.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. I am John, coming from Nerul. In fact, I had some heart problem. Clinically, it is called cardiomyopathy. The thing is that what I was advised by the doctors is that you can do only those things which are only in the comfortable level. See, if I want to run a little bit, I cannot. Suppose I am supposed to get a bus. I cannot just run and get the bus. While walking, if I walk a little bit fast, then that heaviness I was always getting here. So I was under the treatment since the last 10 years. Today when Brother Tom called us in front of this stage, and Brother told me for when you say, when I say number two, he said, see, I could feel that some power has come on my right hand, which I could not control. It was shivering like this. I could feel that. And when the moment it was told three, I immediately touched on my heart. And I strongly feel that the long ailment which was pending since the last 10 years, it has come out. I strongly believe. Thank you. Praise the Lord. And one more testimony I wanted to tell you. This month itself, on 10th of this month, I had some abdominal pain in the night. So I was just neglected. And 11th morning, I was on my way to my office. On my way to office, I could not control the pain. I was driving my vehicle and he stopped on the side and I started vomiting. After reaching to my office, this pain was started, it was increased like anything, and I could not control. From there, I was taken to the hospital in an ambulance. That was the condition. As soon as I reached to the hospital, all the diagnosis, my BP was shoot up, and during the sonography, it was diagnosed as appendicitis. And my ECG, there was a lot of changes in my ECG. All the cardiologists, from the surgical department, all the big doctors gathered immediately and they started the treatment. But the main thing is that as soon as I was admitted in the hospital, but immediately my wife rang to the brother and brother started praying. Whether you believe or not, the morning when I was admitted in the hospital, it was paining like anything. I was crying. I could not control my pain even after giving the over and high dose. I could not control my pain. I was, you know, it was paining very badly to me. After the prayer, slowly the pain came down. And by 3 o'clock on that day, I mean daytime, almost my pain vanished. But again, all the doctors were confused that time. Because the doctors told me, they kept me under observation and for the 48 hours they didn't give me anything. They kept ready me for the surgery, appendix surgery. But the thing is that the doctors were so confused what is happening to this man, because there is no pain. Because with this overan, the pain would have come down for some time, but again the pain should have gone up. But the doctors could not understand what was happening, but myself and my wife understood what happened exactly to me. And without any surgery, on the third day, they gave me the food and they told me, you can book. It seems you are absolutely all right. But they have been and told me to give me go for some tests also. And one more thing I wanted to give a testimony is that since the last 4 years, my son was struggling for the commercial pilot license in Australia. Around 2 years and 10 months he completed that, then he came back. And we were in constant touch with Baba brother and the brother Tom. All of them prayed. This time, last September he left again. I discussed with brother Tom whether I should send him back. Then he said, you send him. Again, what happened is after going to that course, again whatever money he had given for the course that was been taken away by him, that the proprietor concerned left from there, he could not complete the studies. But again, brother prayed a lot, he got a small job there and he got the CPL license also. Thanks a lot. Praise the Lord.